Hey, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do this, that fun, trendy, neon light glowy thingy, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, coming up. Hey, real quick, before we get into this Final Cut 10 tutorial, if this is your first time to my channel and you want to learn more about what it takes to make YouTube videos, gear reviews that'll help you along the way, and tips and tricks and tutorials and all that good stuff when it comes to photography and filmmaking, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when I post my next video. When it comes to doing that neon glow light thingy, again, I don't know what to call it, there's good news and there's bad news. The bad news is it's a plugin and it's not free, but it is only $29.95. You can pick it up from Pixel Film Studios. They have a bunch of really cool Final Cut Pro 10 plugins, but this one we're using is the brush glow effect. The good news is it's super easy, and if I can do it, you can do it. So let's jump into Final Cut Pro 10 and I'll show you exactly what to do. All right, so this is the clip we'll be working with in Final Cut Pro 10. It's already color graded, so once you have your clip, just drop it there in the timeline. And you want to go up here to the titles and generators, scroll down to generators and find the brush glow effect. And you got 1080p, 720, 4K, whatever you're working with. Drop that down in the timeline. I'm just going to trim this up to the length of our clip. So once we've done that, we can select it and then go over here to the right and you can see everything we're working with here. So you can see here, you can do frame by frame, or you can do subsequent frames, which is you just draw it and it goes to each frame, but we wanna do frame by frame for the effect we're looking to do. Then you can choose here the opacity, the glow, the thickness of the brush. You got for deleting brushes if you mess up. Then we can choose the color here. I wanna go with red. I'm a big fan of red. And then for the brush size, I think 8 would be good, so let's do 8. So once we have that all set, we'll go over here to the effect, test it out, make sure the line is thick enough. That looks good. We'll go ahead and clear the frame. Now what I want to look for is I just want to draw the glasses. So I want to see when they first pop into the frame. That looks about right there is the first time the glasses show up. So we'll go ahead and trim the effect to where I want to start. Right about there. So now this is the easy part. All we got to do is select the effect. Oops, got to make sure I'm selected on it. There we go. And you just click with your mouse or on the trackpad and draw. Yeah, it's lagging pretty bad because I'm trying to screen record at the same time of doing this. But yeah, all you got to do is click and draw. Let's see if this ever catches up. All right, there we go. And then when we want to go to the next frame, we'll just right arrow over. Draw again. And since this is lagging so bad, I'll go ahead and speed this up for you guys to the very end. Alright, I've gotten to this point where I've drawn around the glasses for each frame. Now I want the line to start fading out. So as I continue to draw around the glasses, with my hands leaving them. After I'm done with each frame, I'm gonna drop the brush size down one brush until I'm all the way to zero, and that'll give it that fade out look. So let's fast forward till I'm done with that. All right, so I'm done with the glasses. I'm gonna go ahead and trim that up to where I stopped. But now I wanna add another effect. I want some lines going across the middle of the glasses to just mix it up. So I'll drop another frame in, clean it up to just what the clip I'm working with. Go ahead and select that clip. And I think getting some cool like blue electric lines going through the middle would be cool. So we'll choose blue. And same thing, I want those to kind of fade in and then fade out. So I'll start with a low brush, like one, and draw across the glasses. And then each frame, I will increase the brush size. So let's fast forward through that to the end. Now that I'm done drawing around the glasses and fading in and fading out that electric blue line, let's go ahead and see what the final clip looks like. All right, not bad. I mean, it's a cheesy little clip, but I like it. It's really easy to do, other than screen recording at the same time. That really slowed down the computer. But the effect itself is really simple. I mean, you just click and draw, next frame over, click and draw. It's really easy. I'll link it down below if you want to check it out and purchase it and download it. I mean, this isn't a sponsored video, so anyway, if you want to check it out, check it out. Also, before I forget, last Sunday I announced I was giving away a free wireless microphone from Fifine. I still don't know if I'm saying that right. But the winner of this is Brooklyn Dory. She recently started a YouTube channel about doing track and different gear for running track and all that good stuff. I mean, I ran track in high school, so I look forward to seeing how that channel develops, but this will be in the mail for you this week. Hopefully you get it soon and make good use of it. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. But if you really liked it, hey, why not watch one more video? I'll see you in the next video.